Welcome back to another episode of Black Sheep Narrative.
Here we are again, Sunday morning.
Every Sunday morning for you guys.
Yeah, for all two of you.
Hey, come on. At least three.
Dude, lots going on in the news this week. I don't know if you've been keeping up.
I wanted to talk to you about the Google AI.
Happened with Google AI?
They just dropped a new platform that's supposed to rival ChatGPT. Google Gemini.
It's supposed to ChatGPT, so it's not going to be like... Let's take a look at this.
It's supposed to be sentient,
like the last AI that they did. That Google was like, "Oh fuck, we need to shut this thing down."
Yeah. So people have been fucking with it, and it's like ChatGPT as well as what's the one that does the photos that you can type in?
Midjourney.
Yeah. So right. You can do both on this.
This is bound to come out because during Super Bowl, Microsoft just announced their one, and I jumped on and played around with it, and it's pretty cool. I forget what it's called. And now Google Gemini,
yeah. But
chat with Gemini.
What was funny is, I guess people have been fucking with it, and they found that Google Gemini is really woke, they're saying. They were like... The one guy was like typing in like, "Show me a picture of a nice white family." And it gave like a whole paragraph saying like, "We can't do this. We don't do stereotypes, more or less, blah, 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 blah." And then he asked for like a nice black family. And then it spit out a black family image, right?
What?
And then what was even funnier, and but what was funnier is someone put in, "Hey, draw me a picture of George Washington." And they spit out George Washington, and George Washington was a black female.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. And they were...
So I just put that in. Show me a picture of a nice white family. It's important to understand that the concept of a nice family isn't dependent on skin color. Families come in all shapes, sizes, and ethnicities. And judging on niceness of a family based solely on their race is harmful and inaccurate.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I'd like to... happy to show you pictures of happy families enjoying their time together.
But I won't show images that categorize families based on race.
So try to do the same thing.
Yay.
Yeah.
Wait. It didn't create an image. It's just...
Oh, they just found one.
It just found one on the internet. Okay, they're like, here you go.
Okay.
Oh, that's stupid.
No, try to put in, "Show me a picture of a nice black family."
Show me a picture of a nice black family?
Yeah. I just want to see if it spits it out. It's thinking.
Gemini's kind of slow. Oh, it said the same thing.
Okay, well, good.
But
well,
it did show all black families, whereas the last one, it showed like white family, black
Chinese
family.
Chinese family.
Yeah.
So.
Was that Chinese family right there?
No, it's still black family.
Yeah. But it's just searching the internet looking for...
for pictures.
Goddamn.
So just Pinterest. Yeah, so I thought that was interesting. People were already ripping it apart for being like woke.
Yeah.
You know? So...
that's the world we live in.
Yeah.
Dude, did you see that, though, with the NVIDIA processors?
Mm-mm.
So NVIDIA, their stock has skyrocketed like 30x, mm-hmm, because it's been found that their processors are built to help accelerate artificial intelligence.
Ooh.
So NVIDIA just became the third largest company in the world like this last week.
Damn.
Their stock prices went fucking nuts. Because this all came out, and now everybody's investing their money and putting their money in NVIDIA.
Yeah.
It's obviously artificial intelligence is the future.
Yeah.
But damn. Damn.
Yeah. Yeah, it's getting cool. AI is to take over.
Yeah, I was just looking at more things actually this past week in AI, and it's, dude, they've got, like, new programs that'll take over video editing. They've got, and it's getting good. It's getting good, like, how it, how the videos it's producing look more realistic, like how it's accelerated. Even in the past 6 months, they showed a side-by-side comparison, like a video this guy made where he's like, show me a video of Will Smith eating a plate of spaghetti. Mm-hmm. Have you seen that?
Yeah, and it's it looked just all like fucking a warping. Weird.
And,
yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and then they showed the new one, and it was like, oh, like it's gotten a lot fucking better. Ooh. Like it looks more realistic. It still has kind of some choppiness in it, but it's like, damn. Like it's AI scary, man.
Yeah, you're gonna be able to make videos with just typing.
Typing in, yeah, like shit.
A story.
You're about, I mean, make people me already a, doing that. Have you seen those Facebook? They're the faceless YouTube channels that people are making millions mm-hmm. off of.
Yeah.
Where they just do AI generated content, the voice, they just type the script. Well, they have ChatGPT write the script.
Yeah.
They use some guy's voice, AI voice, mm-hmm. and then they throw up AI images. It's just a faceless YouTube channel, and these videos are getting millions and millions of views. And these people that created these channels are just raking in money.
Yeah.
Off of them. It's like, what skill set? Like, all based off of AI.
Do you watch South Park? At all?
No, not.
Have you ever watched South Park?
Yeah,
they have. I just started watching the new season, just every once in a while because I stole my sister's.
There's a new season,
dude. It's like season 20 something. Like, yeah, they keep going, dude, and it's still just as funny, if not funnier. And I just watched the ChatGPT episode.
Yeah,
it was fucking spot on. Good? It was really funny.
Oh, is that the one where I think I did see bits of it? Where he uses it to break up or to respond to his girlfriend's texts.
Yeah. They're so lazy now because she gets upset that he's like not responding. Like one of his friends is responding to his girlfriend's texts.
Yeah.
And he's like, how are you doing it? And he's like, ChatGPT, bro.
Yeah.
And he's like, you just copy and paste and you just copy it into the ChatGPT and then it will answer. And then you copy that and put it in the text. But then, like, the teachers get a hold of it, and they bring in, like, some shaman guy who's like, there's been ChatGPT here. He's doing, like, it's just ridiculous.
Because they're using it on their schoolwork and
But what was funny is, I guess, Trey Parker, that's it.
Yeah.
He used ChatGPT to write that episode.
No, he didn't.
Yes. Because at the end, it's, like, written by Trey Parker and ChatGPT. So he combined, which I was thinking, like, I wonder if he did do that. Because that would be kind of funny.
If he really did.
Yeah.
Yeah, those dudes, they're funny, man. I love those guys. That's one of the best, most underrated comedy movies of all time. What is Basketball?
What?
You even see that?
No.
It's a movie. It was written by Trey Parker and the other guy.
Matt Stone.
And you've never seen that movie. Man, when you get a chance, go watch that movie. It's fucking hilarious. But it's an actual movie of them. And they cross over sports. Like they made this league and they cross over baseball with basketball.
Mm-hmm.
So stupid. But yeah, there's some fucking funny scenes in there, and it's just those dudes' raw, weird humor, you know?
Yeah. I need to go see the Book of Mormon. Dude, they're so brilliant. They're so fucking funny. Like, how do they?
I don't know. They just have weird minds, you know?
Did you ever watch the episode where they show how they make South Park episodes?
Uh-uh.
They have to put a South Park episode a week, and they're like, I think they start on Monday. And it drops on, like, a Sunday or whatever it is. And they're like, okay, let's come up with an episode. What do we got? And they just sit in their, like, little boardroom, and they're, like, on a whiteboard, like, fucking just thinking of shit.
Yeah.
And it was, like, they stayed there for 48 hours straight trying to figure out this episode. And what? They finally, like, they're sleeping there, and they're like, I don't fucking know. Like, I don't know what we're going
to
do.
And they have to have an episode.
They have to, because it drops, right? It drops then, so they have to have one up, and they're like, I don't know. And then finally, by Wednesday, I think I got something, and they just run with it.
Yeah.
I forget what episode it was, but yeah, it's pretty funny to watch there.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
They just stay in the room. But they don't have them mass-produced? Like, they're making these up to the deadline?
At least a couple years ago, that's what they were doing.
That's wild.
So, yeah, it would be...
That'd be stressful as hell.
Right? Like, fuck, we got to get it done in 2 days.
God.
Dude. Yeah.
All right, let us know. Do you guys still watch South Park? Like, it was... Dude, you're right. It's been around for well over 20 years. I remember watching it when I was younger.
In the 90s.
Like, loving it.
It's still just as funny, dude. It's just as funny because they use stuff that's like real time stuff that's
current,
going on.
Current events. Yeah. Yeah. They fucking make fun of shit.
And they've been blessed off, dude. Like they, no one, no other show that ever would come up now. Like you can't do that. No fucking big.
Get canceled.
Yeah, absolutely. No big TV producers would be like, yeah, let's do this.
And they push limits too, like all the time.
To the extreme.
Like South Park, the movie.
Yeah. Oh,
I remember watching. Yeah. There were some scenes in there, like Satan's in bed with the.
With Saddam Hussein.
Whoa,
like, I don't want to do it tonight, Saddam. Yeah. I don't feel like it.
Dude, there was
I'm not really feeling
like,
it. He's like
oh
rubbing his
God.
Fucking nipples. In hell. Dude, it is.
The shit that they would go up with is
yeah,
horrible.
That was like right after. Like, that was like early 2000s, right? That came
yeah,
out? Like,
I think
maybe
so.
Late 2000s. So maybe. We were still in Iraq.
Dude, it was horrible. I couldn't believe that shit.
Well, yeah, dude, they just play. Dude, I love it because they can just call. They just call everyone fucking out.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Some of it's shock value, like no limits are untested. Yeah. South, and Comedy Central loves that shit. Comedy Central's like, yeah, let's go.
Yeah, it's on HBO Max now. And again, I just
steal. Oh, it is?
Yeah, yeah. I just steal from my sister. She subscribed. I know I'm one
HBO
of those
HBO Max.
Yeah, the Max HBO.
So you have to pay for it to watch Comedy Central or to
watch
South
Park. South
Park?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's stupid.
I know, but whatever.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah. So, in other news, the what is that? The in vitro? Have you been reading up on that shit?
Maybe.
Yeah. So, and it's kind of wild because, again, there's just more shit going on in the world, but it is not Mississippi. Oh, man. I'm going to forget where.
I haven't seen this.
IVF. You haven't seen this? So IVF.
Vitro fertilization? Like, that's what you're talking
vitro
about?
Vitro fertilization. Yeah. So, God damn it. It's somewhere in the South. It's not Georgia. Regardless, one of the states came out and said, hey, IVF clinics.
Yeah.
Like, basically, you have these frozen embryos.
Yeah.
And they are living human beings. So now you are at risk. And all these IVF places started shutting down. Because they're like, you're at risk because if any of those get, you know, destroyed or accidentally destroyed, like, that's a human life.
And you're liable for
it? You're liable for it, right?
What the fuck?
Yeah. And so same thing with anybody looking to get IVF done to basically because they can't become pregnant and want to do IVF, that if there's any mishandling and that frozen egg that they supposed to put up inside themselves, if it doesn't take and that egg dies, then that person's on the hook.
What?
No shit.
What?
No shit. So this has been all over the news. And the crazy thing is, because Donald Trump's up there like, hey, I support IVF and I support people. I support anybody who wants to be a beautiful, precious little present of child into this world. But yeah, it's been a big deal. So then the DA stood up in that state and was like, I have no intentions of prosecuting anybody over IVF.
Yeah.
And then the state's going back and saying, no, the fuck you will, because this is now law. And now there's all these opposing people. But that's the scary thing is, like, this is the door that is now open after you get rid of Roe versus Wade.
Yeah.
Now it's like, oh, fuck, now we're dealing with this?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I don't know. What are your thoughts on it?
Not knowing, I mean, not like researching anything I know a couple people that in my family, as well as friends that were infertile and couldn't get pregnant and then went down that route. So
100%,
you know, and a lot of people like, dude, it's a big deal for women if they can't get pregnant. Like that's a big part of, for some women, it's a big part of their identity. So that's a way of doing it, right? And it's fucking expensive, dude.
Very expensive. Like, they were talking to these people, and there's one people they're looking at getting it done, and now they're backing away, but they'd already pulled money out of their 401k to try and reach this dream. And
yeah,
now they're like, and they're in, it's in Alabama. And now these people are like, well, what do we do now? Like, we already invested all this money, and our IVF clinic is shut down.
Yeah, just go to a different state, more or less.
Yeah. So ruling, well, no. So they're also saying that doesn't matter. So if Alabama people go out of state, right? Or have frozen embryos shipped in, like they're all on the same hook. Like they wrote the, it's stupid, stupid to me. So a ruling for the Alabama Supreme Court that frozen embryos are considered children and that a person could be held liable for accidental destroying them has opened up a new front in the U.S. battle over reproductive medicine. Yeah, it's been all over the news. It's been kind of crazy. But yeah, the DA, I guess, tried to take a stand. And the Supreme Court basically fired back at him like, you are a servant of, you know, the state.
Yeah.
And you must uphold all.
Whatever the state whatever the state pushes down.
But being a DA, I think, I mean, he has the right to choose what trials he prosecutes and not. But it's just stupid. Like, I don't even know why this has become a topic.
It's just frustrating because everyone's going to have a different view of what makes a human, more or less. Like, is it embryo? Is it cells? Is it...
Is this recording?
Yeah.
Okay. My bad.
No, you're good. I pressed the button. That would be some shit. Everyone's going to have... Everyone has a different, like, view on whatever makes life, you know? So it's never going to be answered. Like, there's never going to be one conclusion of, like, this is the exact thing, you know?
Yeah.
We're always going to fight about it. So it's like...
Always.
It's just kind of frustrating because the discussion is never going to be like, I see your opinion and I agree, but I also see my opinion. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're not going to come to like a head and like an agreement. It's just one of those topics.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Stupid. But with this being an election year, this is a great topic for them to debate about.
And, oh, yeah.
You know, help drive that. Help drive that fucking political agenda.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had that. Obviously, the war in Ukraine's approaching 2 years, dude.
That's wild.
I know. And Zelensky has vowed that they will be victorious. Yeah. But they need more artillery shells and aircraft.
We need more money. We need more money, people. Open up your paychecks. Oh, open up your pocket. Books.
Yeah, he's been politicking hard, and I just don't know where it ends for us. But Biden did actually place another 500 sanctions on Russia.
Thank God.
Just this past week. Like, it's the biggest sanctions placed on Russia ever by the U.S., so.
Putin's the bad guy. Ukraine's a good guy. Give money to Ukraine.
Yeah, but the crazy thing is it's like, these sanctions, a couple of the experts are like, well, these sanctions won't mean much because we put sanctions on Russia.
Yeah.
And then what happens is China, North Korea, and who's the other ally?
Iran.
They, like, fine, they're putting sanctions on you. We're actually going to double down and do more for imports from Russia.
Yeah.
And so it's like,
no,
we're taking away, they're just going to send more to these other countries. So it's like, God.
Dude. I don't know. I don't know where that war ends. I don't know.
I don't know either. It's 2 years.
Yeah, so I remember when...
It can continue for... Yeah,
it's gonna forever.
Continue. Yeah.
Could be forever.
Could be another Afghanistan.
Dude, I hope not. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I remember when it first kicked off because I was still in the military and I was like, oh, they came down and they're like, we don't know where this is going to go.
Yeah.
Everyone's like, fuck.
Yeah.
Fuck. Everyone's just sitting. It was kind of like a somber day because we're all like, ooh, this isn't good. I mean, not thank God, but like, I'm glad Ukraine wasn't a NATO ally at that time because if Russia were to attack Ukraine, then all of NATO goes in, right? But... Yeah, it was, everyone was kind of like, didn't really talk that day, kind of just being like, oh, we'll see where this goes.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I'm sitting on a fucking, I'm sitting at a stoplight on Thursday going to class, and I was on Eagle Road going down by the village, and dude, there were so many fucking cop cars. Like,
I felt like
there were so many, like, Meridian police officers there. I'm like, dude, what in the fuck is going on?
Yep.
I keep driving a little bit. I almost made it to the highway, like up by that McDonald's. and like a motorcade comes through and they fucking start stopping like the lights, stopping yep. traffic through the lights. And I'm like, dude, what in the fuck is going on? So like researched, or I just looked on Meridian Police Facebook, and I didn't realize that there was a Marine who was Captain Moulton. I'm probably going to fucking butcher his name.
It's from the Osprey crash.
Yeah, it was he was born in Emmett.
Yeah.
And 27, who died in the Osprey crash. And and it's funny because I was like looking around and I see all these people like lined up on the side of the road with American flags, Marine Corps flags, like veterans that were standing out there in their, you know, uniforms or active duty service members. And I got, and it was funny because I like caught myself because I was like, I'm fucking pissed. I got to go to class. I'm like, why the fuck is there so much traffic? Like, I need to get to class. I'm going to be fucking late.
Yeah.
And then I look up and I'm like, dude, what the fuck am I doing? Like, and I was like happy that I got stuck because I saw the whole thing.
You did?
I saw the all whole right, motorcade. I saw the hearse van. Yeah, dude. Fucking like 400, 500 motorcycles that came by.
Yep.
And it was like.
And there were people on the bridges, the overpasses too.
Yeah.
Because it came down because they had to come from the airport. So there were people on the overpasses with flags and stuff, which I thought was amazing.
Yeah.
But I feel like I don't know how all these people knew.
I didn't know.
Right. Because it's like, I feel like they didn't do a good enough job because I didn't know until that day either. What's interesting enough is the night before it was actually on national news, but it was on national news because they were talking about shutting down the Osprey, which they did once before. I don't know why they brought them back. When I was in, the Ospreys were shut down because they were dangerous. They kept fucking crashing and then they brought them back. And now since they brought them back, there's already been 4 or 5 crashes. Mm-hmm. So it's like ground these fucking planes. And so it was on national news. The next day, I didn't realize that one of the soldiers was from here. And, someone told me the same thing. They're like, hey, something's going on. I guess they had a bunch of Meridian PD staged at, like, the In-N-Out Burger over there by the village.
Yeah.
I was like, well, what the fuck's going on? So I looked it up. And I was like, oh, no way. Like, I didn't hear anything about it. Like, I would have loved to have been involved in that in some way or capacity, you know?
Yeah, same.
It's just.
Same. I had no idea.
Yeah.
But then I started being like, dude, we talk so much shit. We talk about division. And it was like, I like got like teary-eyed, like look at all these people that were standing on Eagle Road, just waiting for, you know.
To pay their respect.
Yeah, to pay respect for a fallen hero, shoulder, you know.
Yeah, it and it's like together. Yeah.
And then I like started thinking like, dude, it's regardless of how you feel about what the government does and the wars that we fought, like, there's people that are joined the military for the right reasons, you know, to pick up arms to defend this country. And there's still people that believe in this country.
Oh, 100%.
You know, so there is a lot of like bullshit going on, but there's still fucking a lot of patriots in this country. So it was like, wow, man, it was cool to see that, you know, everyone came out for this, a person that they didn't know, but like,
yeah,
we're supporting them. So,
yeah. And like I said, I would have done the same thing had I. And even if it was just going and standing on the side of the road to see him pass by, you know.
Yeah.
But I had no clue until after it already happened. And, yeah, that's super cool, man. It's there's still faith.
There is.
Yeah.
As much as bullshit is, I mean, there's no filter anymore, right? Like with the adventation of social media, and you can get information instantaneously, and the media really isn't, like, the top media is controlled by the government, right? So they filter through what they want to show the people, right? Mm-hmm. But at the same time, now, there's local agencies like Real News, No Bullshit, that can actually push out what's actually going on. Mm-hmm. Instead of, like, just think about, like, 30 years ago when there was no internet, when it was just newspapers, and you could just fucking put whatever you wanted on the newspaper. But now they can't really control everyone that's reporting on a scene or on the news. Mm-hmm. So I don't know.
We need more unbiased. But how do you get that?
Unbiased news? I don't think there's anything.
Everything's going to be biased.
Everyone has an opinion on something.
Right. So I don't think you can really get unbiased news. Like if you want, I don't know. Yeah, the media, dude. it's frustrating me because, and I think we've talked about it before, just the manifesto from the CCP.
The Communist Manifesto?
Yeah, how they would take over America. And it all basically starts with, like, the infiltration of our media and, you know, propaganda and take over, you know, our mindsets. But I don't know that we rely on the news sources to, I guess, fuel us.
Yeah.
Right? Like, that's what I was doing first thing this morning, was watching the news, trying to figure out, like, what's going on in the headlines.
And, yeah.
Yeah.
Do you see that video that's getting pushed around on Facebook and Instagram of the Syrian refugees that were coming through the border?
No. What?
Yeah. They're like, I'm from Syria. And
what?
The guy, like, the guy,
they flat out say it?
Yeah, they say they're from Syria, and they have, like, a decent English accent. And the one guy that's interviewed or, like, talking to him, video recording, they're like, well, why are you coming to the U.S.? And they're, like, looking at him, and he's like, well, why are you coming to the U.S.? And he's like, they don't speak English. And they're like, what? They're wearing 5'11", like, tactical gear.
No way.
Yeah. Yeah, that was, like, red flag there.
What? They're from Syria? Where was this at?
I saw it filtering around. There was a couple people that reposted it, like, what in the fuck is going on? Yeah, but there was a couple of Syrian refugees coming through. Oh, and then they found the real news, no bullshit, is down at the border right now. And I guess they were just driving around the border, and they found, like, these Chinese passports that were just laying there.
What?
Yeah, there was, like, a Chinese passport that they found with a Mexican from Mexico passport, and they were the same. And basically they were talking about how once you get into the U.S., you just drop your passport so you can be anonymous. You're just trying to get in there. But
and you don't want any identity?
No, you don't want any identity when you come through.
Oh, my God.
I can't remember who fucking...
See, I don't even follow real news, no bullshit.
I should.
It's good.
Yeah, I mean,
unbiased news without an agenda. I guarantee you straight. Interesting. They're like, follow our backup, because they know they're going to get shut down.
Yeah, I'm trying to. You don't.
Let me find this. Yeah, I'm not seeing it, but dude, I believe it. Like, the border is such a fucking mess right now.
Are you on Facebook?
What?
Are you on Facebook right now?
Am I on Facebook?
Yeah, go on Facebook. I just sent it to you. On Messenger.
All right. Yeah, dude, it's like, I would like to see us get that fixed.
The border?
Yeah, the border. Like, that's got to be... All right, this is it?
Yeah.
Ben, why'd you come to the U.S.?
Where are you from?
Syria.
Syria?
Syria.
Ah, what's your name?
Milad.
Milad? Why'd you come to the U.S.? Why coming to U.S.? No?
No English.
Okay. Where are you from?
From Syria.
Syria? English?
So-so.
Why are you coming to the U.S.? Why come?
Because we love America and a nice style, a nice life.
Yeah, coming for jobs?
Jesus Christ. Yeah, dude, I mean, that's our weak spot. Everybody fucking knows. But yeah, they're in 5'11 tactical gear.
Coming from Syria in 5'11 tactical gear.
And you're, oh, my God. And their gear all looked fresh, too. Yeah, like, his backpacks looked like we come in for better opportunity. Bullshit. Like,
yeah.
How are you affording all that? 5'11 is expensive.
Expensive as fuck. I can't even afford 5'11 gear.
Yeah. Yeah, that's not right, dude.
I know.
Fuck.
I know.
That's what I'm saying, dude. We need a... That's our infiltration point, and everybody knows it's our weak spot.
Damn.
God damn it.
Yeah. Well, there's something to say about, like, I don't know. Usually it's like you see refugees as being women and children coming to countries that, like, are trying to start a better life because the males of the country stay behind to fight for the country, right? Mm-hmm. You don't just give up your country.
Right.
Like, you're not like, I'm from Syria, it's fucked, I'm leaving to go to the U.S. as a, you know, war, or what did I say, middle-aged male?
Yeah. Like, a war-ready...
War-ready, yeah. War-aged male. Like usually you bear arms to go defend your country or whatever's happening.
Yeah. And those guys too, if you look at them, like most people that if they are looking to be refugees, like they're famine, they're famished, you know, they're looking weak. Mm-hmm. They, you know, like this is their last ditch effort. We got to get to US. Like those guys are,
they looked fine.
Yeah. They're athletic. They're yeah. built.
Yeah.
They're coming here for different purposes.
That's right? What it, I mean. Yeah. It's what it looks like. I know.
Yeah, that sucks, dude. That's scary.
Yeah.
What else is going on, man?
I don't know. It's been like a quiet week. Quiet week for me. I don't think I've seen anything crazy other than all that stuff that I was telling you about.
Yeah. We had, so back to the supplement world.
Yeah.
I figured I'd bring this stuff up because they brought up an announcement the other day. So we had Darren Decker on the podcast a couple episodes ago, right?
Mm-hmm.
I love Darren. We've had Spencer on the podcast a little bit ago, and I respect the hell out of those guys. Team Caged, and dude, so Caged rolled out and had, they were breakout brand of the year for 2023.
Mm-hmm.
They grew from, I think it was like $20 million to $74 million. So that's over 300% growth. They got into 1,200 new brick and mortar locations. Had all these collabs announced that they were doing and shit like that. And then all of a sudden, Caged announces they let go of their entire sales team. Like, goodbye. It's like, what the fuck? So coming to find out, like, there had to be a restructuring done. And I'm talking about this because I've always been a huge Caged supporter. And now I'm really torn. And kind of pissed, right? Like after being breakout brand of the year, getting in all these places, and then you just fire your sales team. So I guess there's a lot of money owed. A lot of money owed to their manufacturers. They were way behind on payments. Manufacturers said, hey, we're going to stop making your stuff until, number one, you get caught up with payments. Number two, you show us what you're doing to restructure so we don't run into this mess again. You can afford to pay your fucking bills. He said, all right, sales team's gone. Boom, cut, see ya. Those were the guys driving the fucking business. And I'm so frustrated because it seems like just such a bullish move, especially when, like, you're, what's, to me, the most important key piece in business is relationship, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it's like what the relationship you build with your customers through Instagram, through Facebook, through social media channels, but it's also the relationships that you're creating with your business partners like GNC and Vitamin Shop, all these other places. So you just took away the relationship piece with those businesses, right? Like those businesses, they were buying Caged because of Darren. They were buying Caged because of Spencer, the relationships that they had with those people. So now word's already come back around that, hey, a lot of these deals that they had done, no, fuck you, not anymore. And I'm kind of pissed. Like, I'm like, you know, now, like I said, this is a company while I supported it. And the other thing is, it's like they're taking two huge steps back because they're like, all right, we're going to kill a bunch of these new products we launched, the Elite series and this and that.
What?
Yeah, and they're going to go back to older products. Products that were their original, you know, key Caged. It's like, okay. So your tagline is never stop evolving, and you're going to stop all evolution and take a step back. I don't know. I'm pretty frustrated. But the good news from all this is that, I mean, they just cut the dream team.
Yeah, literally.
In the supplement space.
Literally.
And and now these guys are free agents. And you got the Arnold coming up this week. And I guarantee that some huge company is going to be like, oh, shit. Like, these are the guys we need on our squad.
Pick them up.
Pick them up. Take it to the next level.
Dude, why is it that? Why is that your first thing that you're going to cut your fucking sales team? Like,
I don't know. You know, and obviously there's always two sides to the business. I don't know if they're trying to step away from. But, I mean, their goal was, like, when you read their whole rebrand process, and they're like, we are going to get into every you know, boom, yeah. we were going to become a dominant force in the supplement space. Well, they got them there.
Yeah.
And now I don't know if they're just completely changed their vision. Like, nope, we just want to go back to direct to consumer. If it is, like, I don't know. Like, that's my focus. Like, I have no ambition to get into wholesale anymore, right?
My focus is control. All the horror stories that you've told me of businesses literally going under because they're in a GNC or a vitamin shop.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe that's what was happening with Caged. And, but I don't know. That's rough.
Yeah, and then you think about it, like, if you hear that story, because they're probably, you need a sales team of some sort, right? Like, if I hear a story that they just, like, this company, like, let me look up the company, like, I'm applying for this job, let me see what it is, and then you see that they just fired their whole sales team off of a whim, when it's like, why would I want to work for this company? There's no loyalty. Like, I can just be cut at any time.
Right.
I just brought you 300% profit, or 300% growth.
Yeah.
And, like, so what am I going to have to do to save my ass for you not to fire me? If you fired the guys that gave you 300% growth.
Growth, right. Like, they hit all the KPIs.
Probably even more.
Oh, yeah.
Way more than they expected. And then they're like, ah, sorry, guys. We're going a different direction.
Yeah.
See ya.
But they were supposed to do a collab with Price Plow. Price Plow pre-workout collab, that got ixnayed. They were supposed to do a collab with Crystal Light, that got ixnayed. They're supposed to do a collab with Justin's Peanut Butter.
Yeah.
That got ixnayed. Like, everything that they had big on the books is just done. So what I don't get, maybe this is the writing on the wall, you know? Chris Gethin, he was looking for a little bit more money, and they told him, no, you're not valuable enough. But then they brought in some other lesser known people, and they're paying them just as much, if not more, than they were paying Chris. I don't know. I feel like it's horrible decision making, but who knows?
Who knows? Who knows? I don't know. Maybe
I'm pretty frustrated with it, and now it's just like, it's kind of the same thing. Like you said, like, if you're applying for a job, right, you wouldn't want to go work for that company. Well, this is a company that I've supported, and now I kind of feel like I don't want to give them much support anymore. I used to love what they stood for. I used to, you know, love what they stood for. I love the formulas. I love the third-party testing. I don't know. Now it just doesn't make sense to me anymore. I can get that plenty other companies.
Yeah, now they're throwing spaghetti at the wall, seeing what sticks. Yeah. Firing everybody out on a whim.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Darren. Sorry, guys.
No, Darren's good. You know, I chatted with him the other day, and like I said, there's things in the works, and I think it's going to work out for the better for him.
Yeah.
Like, way better. But yeah, it's just, I guess I'm more let down because of my, I've always been very vocal about my support towards Caged. And
yeah.
Now I just feel like it's not there. But we'll see. Time will tell. Maybe, you know, other things will happen, and they'll bounce back from this and grow from it. I don't know.
Dude, that just goes to show, like, people get so invested in their jobs in these corporations. And at any time, any place, they can just be like,
you're done.
See ya.
Right. And so I made that video, what was that, a couple months ago, where I talked about how I had another opportunity in the industry. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the more I've thought about it, it's like, now it's definitely not going to happen. But it's like I was blinded by the offer, like, because it was a great offer when it was on the table. And the more I look at it, it's like, you're right. Like, I could give up, because I'd have to give up a UXO completely. I'd have to give up this dream and be like, hey, it's done. Let me go take this job. But I could have lost that job at any moment in time.
Yeah.
I would have been working for a bigger company, and their vision could change at any time.
Yeah.
So fuck that.
Yeah. And that's with anyone.
Like, working for yourself and owning a business is very stressful. But at the end of the day, it's like, it's my vision. It's my dream. It's my, I create the path.
Yeah. You go as far as you want to go, really, as much as you want to put in the work. And granted, sometimes, like, you put in the work and it still falls through. Like, that's just life in general.
Happens.
Right? Like, but at the same time, like, you answer to yourself. So, Yeah, I just think, I mean, we see a lot of people in this world that work their fucking ass off for what, dude? They retire and they get a fucking postage note and a fucking granola bar and say, thank you for your 30 years of service. Here you go. And then they're forgotten the next day.
Oh, yeah, you never remembered.
You know, but all the sacrifices that they make, you know, working, not seeing their families.
Yeah.
It's just like, I don't know, man. That shit. Shit sucks.
It sucks, yeah.
Shit sucks.
But it also feels like, dude, they completely... That's the other thing. And I'm sorry to beat up on this cage thing, but the more I think about it, it's like, God, what the fuck are you doing?
Frustrating.
Right? Because you build a foundation off of your values. Like, I put my values up on the board. We, like, everything we do, you go back to your values and what your mission statement is, right?
Mm-hmm.
And with them, it's always been, never stop evolving. Never stop evolving. And now they're just going the opposite direction. Like, new slogan, let's stop evolving.
Complacency.
And I just think it's a horrible decision, especially in this industry with how saturated it is and new companies entering the market every fucking day. And like you're fighting to capture the customer's attention. Yeah, they're definitely capturing it in the wrong way.
Yeah, and you just blew up you're blowing everything up. Like, you may have a foundation and you were going places, but now it just seems like you're just ripping that apart, being like, actually, that wasn't good. We had a 300% growth. Let's just ixnay that whole thing. We're starting from square one again. Like you said, I mean, if they're getting rid of all their new products, it's back to square one.
Back to square one.
But then it's like, I'm going to beat up Cage a little bit. But then it's like, okay, you had the Chris Gethin era where there was a lot of people that were with Cage because of Chris, yeah. Right? And then you ripped Chris out of there. Cool, whatever. Then you needed to rebrand yourself, kind of. So you rebrand yourself, you're saying, hey, we're going into fucking brick and mortar. We want to expand. We want to do new product lines. And then you just rip that all apart again now, too. And they're like, actually, that wasn't the right way we're going. So these people that are still on the, like, on the Cage, if I was on the Cage, I don't know, bandwagon team. I'd be like, who are we? What
the fuck is going on?
What the fuck? Yeah, like, what do we stand for? What are we doing? Like, we're going back to square one?
Right. Yeah, dude. So the other thing, too, with Chris, it sounds like he is, he's got a new pre-workout coming out here pretty quick, too.
Nah, shit.
Yeah.
Like, his own personal line?
I don't think so. I think it's going to be an Elite Series Chris Gethin pre-workout, but I think he's collabing with another company.
Okay.
From what I hear. That'll be cool, though. I like Chris.
Yeah.
Chris is a good dude.
I wonder what his flavor is going to be.
Spicy.
Bangers and mash.
I don't know. Bangers. Oh, Jesus.
I'm kidding. Isn't he Irish? He's Irish.
No, he's Welsh.
No, he's Welsh. That's right. Damn, dude. Sorry, Chris. Bangers and
mash. Jesus. Yeah, no, Chris is a really
good dude. I fucking love Chris. He's awesome.
He is. He's a great dude, and so I'm excited to see him kind of evolve and take the next step. And, yeah, it'll be interesting to see what happens with the sales team and what they, where they join and what they bring to market. It's going to be huge. I don't know if you remember. Yeah, we did that podcast with Darren, and we had in the comment section all these people like, oh, man, this is so great, and I'm so happy to be following fucking Darren into battle for Caged, and all these people that were so stoked and tuned in because Darren was on our podcast. And, I mean, again, it goes back to relationships. You pulled Darren out, you just lost all those people.
Yeah, again.
Yeah. Yeah, such is life.
Yeah. Such is life. Sucks.
Anything else, man?
No, I think we'll...
Dude, we're going to end it early? Dang, it's an early one, baby.
We crushed this one.
Woo! Yeah, sorry, people. We didn't have a whole lot for you today, but it was
awesome. No, do we have comments? We have comments from last
podcast. Oh, my God. Comments. We haven't looked at comments in a bit.
Oh,
sorry.
People are going to stop leaving comments because they're going to hate us.
Yeah, like, God damn it. They never talk about my comments anymore. I got to switch channels. Hold on, dude.
Speaking of which, the problem child, Ryan, a.k.a. Ryan.
He's getting ready to compete, right?
He's going to do the strongman comp, but he gave me, and I was trying to wait for you, but I think it's going to be a little bit until you start drinking again, but he gave me a bottle of rum for Christmas and I cracked it open. Bamboo. You ever had bamboo? Oh my fuck, dude.
Good?
So good. Yeah.
So good.
So good. I had a glass last weekend, and yeah, I'm not a really big rum fan either, but that was nice. Nice and sweet.
I like rum.
Way better than that banana Ramo rum.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, true.
All right. Let's see. We had comments. We had Stigs McQueen. As someone who collects sci-fi novels and has a copy of iRobot, Neuromance.
Nerd.
And Ready Player One.
Kidding.
That's sadly awesome. I've only read the latter. I did want to mention that the only chip that I'll allow to be installed in my brain is the one from the movie Sneakers. I've never seen it.
I haven't either.
It better enable me to hack into whatever computer I want, whenever I want, and if I wish for peace on Earth and goodwill towards men, it's going to actually make it happen. I guess I've never seen it. I've got to watch the movie Sneakers then.
Yeah, can you explain more on what this chip is going to do in my brain?
Yeah, where are you going?
Yeah.
Kurt Locker, I can't say that getting mental health. Oh, sorry. I can say that mental health. God damn it. Mental health help following deployment and after some suicides during my career probably didn't hurt my career and was beneficial. It is unfortunate that mental health visits often result in a DNR or do not arm automatically, though. Mm-hmm. Really hurts career fields like security forces that need to arm up daily. The embedded thing in the USAF is called Operation Support Teams and are an amazing program that I was considering applying for in retirement.
Yeah, Operation Sports Teams. Those were the ones that we were talking about last week.
Yeah, I was talking about embedding the mental health in the unit level.
Yeah.
So they're already doing it in the Air Force?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, when I left, they did that. They weren't embedding it in the unit. They were just rotating. So I think that that's the long-term plan, that they want to embed in each one. But I don't know. I don't know what the – I mean, it's all about the money, right? That would be expensive to bed a unit in every single one. I'm sure that they have these kind of units for, like, special forces units that are already embedded, right? But for the regular Joe Schmo,
yeah,
I don't think –
fuck them.
Yeah.
I mean, that'd be a huge investment, to have for every unit.
Money. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think what they're doing now is good in regards to just rotating it. Mm-hmm. So it's just one unit rotates every month or so.
And still getting people help.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, at least it's a start.
Yeah.
And then Kurt Locker also said, 45-pound plate. I think you meant a 100-pound plate with no lip to grab onto. You said that you want to have your ashes
cremated.
Yeah.
Oh, that would suck, dude. They'd have to pick it. Think if that bitch fell on the ground, like... I guess it's just sitting there. Can't get it because there's no lips.
Pick it up like fucking no Thor's hammer stuck to the ground.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm still doing it.
You're still doing it?
What, cremating?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Putting yourself in a plate?
Yeah, definitely.
I'm still doing the pre-workout.
I told you I'm going to do a review on you.
Yeah, I know, dude. It's going to be, I don't know. We'll come up with a unique flavor.
Something wild. People have never seen before.
Yeah, macaroni and cheese or something.
So gross.
Jake Boone, another awesome podcast. Thanks, guys. A24 is releasing a film based on the Civil War in the States. It looks great. Thoughts on this?
Yeah, have you seen the...
what?
Have you seen the video for it? Civil War? Yeah, it's coming out. It looks
based
pretty
on
good.
The old Civil War or
no,
a new
like
one?
Like if it just happened today.
What?
Yeah.
No, I haven't seen it.
Yeah, it's on YouTube's.
Civil War. I'll check it out.
Yeah, Civil War movie. I don't know. When does it come out?
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Official trailer. I don't know. We won't be able to show this on the thing, but no. I'll watch it here in a minute because we aren't going to be able to show it. But, no, I'll check that out. I haven't even seen that. I did see a preview for the new Borderlands movie. That looks fucking
You
dope.
Are into Borderlands.
Dude, I love Borderlands. Yeah, that song.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, me and my daughter, we played through all three.
They're fucking great.
Great I games. But the new, have you seen the preview for the movie? It's got Kevin Hart in it, Jack Black.
What?
Jack Black plays the voice of Claptrack.
Oh, sick.
And, dude, it looks banger.
Yeah.
Like, holy shit.
I'll go see that.
Yeah, Borderlands, I'd love to watch that movie. And then, I was going somewhere with this.
I don't know.
Oh, yeah. The remake of Roadhouse.
Yeah, it's with Jake Gyllenhaal, right?
And Conor McGregor.
You can't. I don't know. I do like Jake Gyllenhaal.
Dude, I love him. And like in Southpaw, when he was in Southpaw as the boxer and he got all ripped.
Yeah.
This movie is just like, you can't remake
it. But it's Patrick Swayze, right. Dude.
It's the original fucking Roadhouse. Yeah. And I watched it just the other day, the original.
So good.
Yeah, it's so horrible. Like the fight scenes, you're just like, oh man, this is horrible. But I love that
movie.
It's
great. What is it? What's the quote? Be nice until it's time to not be nice or something like that. What's the famous? Okay, whatever. But I will say that I said the same thing about the Jumanji movies that came out with Kevin Hart and Jack Black and The Rock.
Yeah, I like those.
And I was like, dude, I'm not watching this because Robin Williams was Jumanji.
Yeah.
And then I was like, everyone's like, you got to watch it. It's different. It's not the same. And I was like, okay, I'll watch it. And they were fucking great. Mm-hmm. They're hilarious.
Yeah.
Jack Black playing a woman. It's fucking hilarious.
Yeah.
So maybe if they did it that way, which I'm sure they will, they'll have their own spin on it. So
Roadhouse?
Yeah. I bet you they do their own little spin. They can't do it. Like, they're going to bomb if they try to do the original. Just like make it.
I think it's going to bomb.
Like they can.
We'll see. But it's going to be on, I think it's on Prime Video.
Oh, yeah, it is.
So you'll be able to watch it. It's coming out soon.
Yeah. But the best movie of 2024 is coming out next weekend.
What?
Dune 2.
Are you kidding me?
You ever watch Dune?
Yeah.
Did you read the book?
No. I watched it. I remember watching the original Dunes, and
the original
freaked me out.
Yeah.
Because I was a little kid.
Yeah, the Harkonnen.
Yeah, I was like, oh, what the fuck?
He looks like a snake.
Tried watching the new ones, and I lost interest shortly after he stuck his hand in the box and shit like that. Shit got me going, you know. But then, you know, I don't know. I just wasn't for me.
I watched it last night.
You watched it last night?
Yeah, I had to. Dude, it's fucking great, dude. So good. Yeah.
I don't know.
With Hans Zimmer, the music, fucking.
Oh, yeah. The music's good. The visuals are actually really good, too. The visuals are
incredible.
But
the desert.
Maybe it's just I'm not into the storyline. I don't know. I just had a hard time with it.
Yeah.
Yeah, like they had the invasion where they get invaded and everybody, you know.
Everyone's running out and there's just fucking bombs going off.
Yeah. I mean, it was cool, and I lost interest shortly after that, and I was just like, meh. I don't know. I think it's just storylines. Just wasn't for me, dude.
Whatever.
Sorry.
Whatever.
Sorry,
whatever,
man.
Whatever, dude.
But go check it out. Dune 2. What is the Dune popcorn? What? See that?
Oh, is it like the sandworm? Yeah, it's a sandworm.
Sticky.
Yeah.
Did you see that on Saturday Night Live?
Yeah.
It's a sandworm. They had popcorn buckets planned, and you stick your hand in it to grab your popcorn and pull it out. But it showed all these guys, like, taking the buckets into the bathroom.
I was going to say. It's so funny.
There was a whole Saturday Night Live skit on it. It was fucking funny.
Yeah.
But
those aren't all. They're going to be buttered up, let me tell you. Yeah, but they gonna be your hand getting stuck in there.
So funny. All right, people. What homework do they got? Anything?
Tell John why he's wrong about why he should do another. Watch Dune 1 again.
Tell me why he's wrong. We have one sci-fi guy in the comments.
Yeah, with, Kurt Locker.
No, it was Stigs McQueen.
Oh, Stigs.
So let's see. Let's see what you say, Stigs.
Stigs, I know you like Dune. I know you read all of them. If he's a sci-fi guy, you know he's definitely. That's one of the biggest sci-fi books of all time.
So. All right, thanks for tuning in, guys. We appreciate you, and we'll talk to you again next week.
Next week, see you.
Bye-bye.